Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do some absolutely gorgeous wedding nails. I would say this would be the last of the wedding nails for this season because summer is coming to an end.
Oh, what about a winter wedding?
A winter wedding would be lovely as well. Mm. If anybody wants winter wedding nails, come and find me. So we've got the gorgeous Karen in, and Karen's wedding is tomorrow. So I am going to create a set of nails for Karen that's inspired by bits and bobs she's brought in to show me. So let's have a look. Oh, I love them. Do you know what? They're a really good height as well.
Yeah.
Because when you have big heels.
It's... Why did you look at me there? I don't wear heels.
Adam, come on now. Tell them the truth. But no, because I would imagine big, massive high heels aren't, like, for the whole day, you'd be kicking them off. But they
especially
are.
Especially designed for weddings.
They're not massive.
No.
No.
I could never
That's
walk
not
in
a massive
anything
heel.
Like that.
But look how beautiful they are. So what I'm going to do is draw inspiration from the shoes. So we've got like the lace, gorgeous beading and embroidery, and obviously a bit of bling, Doc. A bit of bling. So I want to see, I'm not going to put it on the table because that's bad luck, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Why is that bad luck?
Table, yes.
Did you never put
new shoes on the table.
So yeah. You put all shoes on the table. But yeah. Surely that would be bad luck because they'll be dirty.
Oh, that'd just be messy. Especially with football boots. But no, they are beautiful. So, is Rachel Simpson like does she make shoes for weddings?
She does, yeah. So, they're supposed to be comfortable.
Yeah, well, they look very comfortable.
They feel it for 5 minutes.
Right.
Because that's all I've had them on.
Oh, you've had them on for 5 minutes, yeah. Okay. Yeah. I love them. And you'll ever wear these again, won't you? I think you'll wear them again.
Christmas.
Yeah, definitely. You'd have to wear them again. They're too beautiful to not wear.
Too expensive as well, not wear again.
Are they a bit expensive, don't
they?
Well, you only get married once or twice or three times anyway.
Second.
Any excuse for a party, Karen?
Yeah, yeah.
There you are. I'll give you them so you can put them on the floor and we don't add any bad luck. We don't want any bad luck. And then Karen has, on my phone, got a picture of a dress, and I will turn that on silent. But I've not seen the dress, so we'll have a look at the dress. Oh my god, that is absolutely unbelievable. Oh, get it back, where's it gone? Oh no, we don't want that one.
What have you done, Kirsty?
There. That is absolutely amazing.
Mine's just ivory underneath there rather than that.
That flesh tone.
Yeah.
So it's got that similar kind of theme going on all the embroidery and the bits of beading. I love it. It's very 1950s.
Yeah.
I love it. I absolutely love it. So, gives me ideas. We'll do a bit of hand painting. We'll do some sheer nails, I think, as well. Because it's sheer here.
It is, yeah.
Yeah.
In the back.
In the back sheer as well. And we'll use the tones. So there's a silver in those shoes as well, isn't there? So we'll use
silver.
Also use silver and nudes and white. And ivories. I like it. I wish I was getting mine. Don't do too.
It's very stressful.
I think I just want the dress.
Maybe
I just buy a wedding dress.
Yeah.
And just prance around in it and have nice pictures.
Yeah. Apparently people do cleaning in the wedding dresses.
Oh, just to get the use out of them.
Yeah.
It's a bit dangerous, I think. What with bleach and all. I think you could wear that again. Would you dare?
Yeah, Christmas keeps coming back on.
Do you know what? You could have this made into a short version. Oh. Because you know we've got Christmas, Alton Towers Christmas do going on. I think you should have that made shorter. Now we know what we're working with. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pick out some colours and some bit of sparkle. I think we need some like soft white iridescent kind of glitter as well. Yeah. So I'll get the colours out now. So these are the colours that I've got out. I've got Diamonds Are Forever, Silver Sparkle, and Disco Diva, Snow White Shimmer, Acrylic
Powder.
Snow Queen Shimmer, Acrylic. Yeah, okay. Metallic Pink. I've got some Silver Cracked Mylar. I've got some Loose Silver Glitter. I've got White, Lunar Blush, and Rose Glow. And I've also got some of the tiny AB crystals. So, and I might just use a bit of this as well. And we might use a bit of this foil as well.
Can you imagine what's going to happen when Faye gets
and
married?
And we might use a bit of this. And we might use a bit of this. I've got them all out just in case I need them. I think Faye's having an effect on me.
I think so too, because that's a lot of product.
It's a lot of product, isn't it?
Yeah.
However, this tutorial I'm going to show you now will be using these colours, these crystals, and a bit of this silver sparkle. Exciting. Okay, so we're going to push back the cuticles of Karen's tiny fingers. She has tiny hands, tiny fingers, and your skin is so soft. It's like virgin skin. Not sure it is.
Maybe not.
And everything looks a lot bigger on camera. Believe me, it ain't. And you are all so rude. Right, I am very slightly just going to skip over the cuticle area, and I'm going to be really gentle because these are very delicate cuticles. I'm going to take that shine off, got a 180 grit file, very light pressure. When was the last time you had your nails done, Karen?
About 6 weeks ago.
Yeah, so they do look quite fresh still. What do you normally have done?
Just the extensions, the tips.
Yeah. Have you ever had them sculpted?
I haven't, no. I wanted to.
Oh, well, it's your lucky day. So I'm taking off the free edge and leaving the tiniest bit. This is just going to really clean up the nail. What shape do you want?
Those, what you've got.
Yeah. Ballerina.
Yeah.
Right, so I fit that so it fits just underneath that slight free edge. I'm making sure it really does fit right under there. So I'm using a tool just to help because Karen's fingers are super tiny. Close the form. Give it a nice shape. So I'm going to close that down to the number 3. And we'll go to about, what, you want to go to about there?
Yeah.
Yeah, 1.5?
Yeah.
Wow, that is the smallest nail I ever did see. Sure you don't want to go to 2?
Let me look. That's 2. No.
1.5?
Yeah.
1.75?
One and three quarters.
Will you? Are you going to be all right? Yeah. In case I can't do anything.
I'll tell you tomorrow.
You'll tell me tomorrow. Go, I can't do anything. Oh my God. no, do you have fingernail file with you? Take them down for me because I can't do a thing.
I'll text you later.
I'm like, I can't put my shoes on. My gorgeous shoes have cost me a fortune. I can't even fasten them.
That's what bridesmaids are for.
Yes. Slash servants.
Yes. My minions.
Yes. Right, so I'm going to dehydrate this nail now using the nail prep dehydrator. And then we're going to use the acid-based primer. Tiny amount. So all I'm doing now is putting my thumbs either side and making sure that really fits nice and tight. That's going to help with the structure of the nail and the strength. What I'm going to do first of all is just lay down a very thin layer of Luna blush. Now, this is like a soft whitey pink. It's slightly transparent if you do it very thin. And that's kind of what I want, really. I just want this sort of little base layer. I'm using a size 6 oval sharp. And this is a smaller brush. It's actually the first time I've used this brush, so... But it's perfect for this size of nail. If I'd got the size 12 out or the 10 or even the 8, I would probably find that a little bit difficult. I'm a lot more controlled with this size 6. I mean, some people think you can have a brush for everything, but it is good to have a few different sizes, even if you have even a size 12 and a 10. Oh my god. So I'm making contact with the natural nail, but then I'm creating the length. Just want a little bit more on that natural nail. So I can pick up nice small beads for this tiny nail. Right, I'm going to use the white now. I'm going to put that right at the end because I just want something that's quite bright just at the tip. And I'm going to blend that up. Ryan, then we're going to use Rose Glow, which is one of the nice, gorgeous nude colours. It's going to give the nail a little bit of a lift and act like a foundation colour. I'm going to blend that over. What we're going to do now is use the Luna blush and come in the centre with that. I'm going to blend back here. And then I'm also going to blend it onto that white. So this will add like a ghosting effect to this ombre. Because the Luna blush isn't as pigmented as a white, it will give you a nice ghosting effect to help everything blend together perfectly. Then I'm going to add a little bit of true pink. So you can see it's ever so slightly pink. It's a transparent colour. It won't add any pigment. but it'll add the slightest amount of pink. And all I'm doing is making sure I've got this apex built up. That's all I'm using that for. So I know it's not going to diminish any of the colour. And it doesn't matter if it adds just that slight pink to the colour at the back. I'm going to let that set a little bit and then I will come in and pinch. So I've given that a little bit of a pinch so we've got a little bit more of a C curve, and it's aesthetically pleasing to the eye because it's a little bit thinner. So now it's set, I'm going to take that off. I'm going to start with filing this free edge to get those side walls nice and straight. Smooth the cuticle area, and I'll contour the rest of the nail. Just going to buff over this nail now, make it nice and smooth. Right, I'm just going to wipe over it with pure acetone to clean the nail up and also smooth the nail as well. Right, what we're going to do now is we're going to use the clear aquagel, because I'm going to be putting stones onto this nail. I'm going to scrape off a small amount. I need gel residue in a dampened dish. So that gel residue wipe off solution. I'm just going to roll that on. Then I'm just going to smooth this out. And apply it nice and thin. Just scrape off a little bit of that. You want a thin, even layer, fading to pretty much nothing at the tip. Right, so now I'm going to top coat this. I'm not going to cure that aquagel. I'm top coating. And what this will do is it'll make the nail not have any sticky layer. And it'll also, the aquagel will act as the adhesive to stick all the crystals on with. So I'm going to use some of these as well. So this is from the wheel number 14. It's unbelievable. Right, so what I'm going to do now is apply these little metal pieces and create a flower. So kind of like the shoe has this flower on there. We have a flower, and then we're going to put a little stone in there. So the cool thing is you can still move things around. It's not going to, you know, fall off, and it's not going to set. If you use it using acrylic, then you really wouldn't have much play time at all. So, and then what I'm going to do now is I need a little bit of, I've got a little bit of top coat on the end of my dotting tool because I need to be really controlled with this part, and I'm going to go around the metal pieces and surround them with these tiny stones. You want to just press those in to the gel, and it's going to give it that beaded effect like there is on the shoe. Alright, pop me that in the lamp. A little bit of cuticle oil. So that's got no sticky layer. You just want to watch that on your lace and things like that. Because it is textured. So it just draws in those sort of silver parts of the shoe. The fact that it's a flower on there and those little beads as well. And she can still get her ring on that nail. There you go, guys. Hope you enjoyed that video and the beautiful nail that we've created for the beautiful Karen for her wedding day tomorrow. Everything I've used today will be listed below, as always. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.
You should see us then when we walked into that posh bit. It was hilarious. All the women, because they'd all got like the chiffons and the proper like
ball
just gowns red.
And everything.
Yeah, but they weren't nice ball gowns.
No, they were just that,
like, and we walked in, us three. We went on the dance floor, didn't we? All the men were just like.